season is hit high gear, and off we go in week 11 on EA Sports. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Play action, now it's Lance. And oh, right away, he lost the football. And this is recovered by the Chargers. He let one slip away last week as well, so now two fumbles lost in as many weeks.
But we were out of practice, and we watched him work. And what did his quarterback coach talk about all week?
Being a two-hand monster.
And we looked at each other, two-hand. Oh, I get it, two-hand monster. Both hands on the football, taking care of it, putting it away so the ball doesn't get dropped.
And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
They're looking at a 2nd and 8 now from the 10. You can't block me. You can't block
me. Throwing now is Murray. Eluding the pressure right. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up 3rd down. 8 yards to go. Well, good field position to start the drive, but under the gun now here on 3rd and 8.
I'm going back to you. I'm going back to you. Watch twist, watch twist, watch twist. Here
you go. Watch twist. Big A's open, big A's open. Shoot.
I got him. He's mine, he's mine, he's mine.
49. Here's Murray as he sets to throw it. Flush to his right. And this is intercepted, but they'll say out of bounds. Oh, very close to a turnover there in the end zone.
That was an interesting look there because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well, and kudos to you. You didn't jinx it.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it.
Could you sense the relief, though, when they only gave up the field goal? And they were able to trot back out on the field and start this drive. A little more pep in their step because they didn't cost their team a touchdown. But they know they've got to do it a lot better than they did on the last possession.
The coach will just be relieved, though, if they recoup with a score here, right?
I think coach will be ecstatic to see them pick themselves back up and now take it downfield, punching the end zone without turning it over.
They faked the handoff. Now Lance
escaping the pressure right. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. He'll get 5 out of the scramble. It's 2nd down.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him. But instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir. Able to turn that into a positive gain. On 2nd down, this is Harris. And he's going to get this inside the 30.
Lance now on 1st down.
He gets a complete to Harris. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. A completion, yes, but certainly not what they wanted. A loss of a full 6 yards. Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one. To throw again on 2nd down. Lance flushed out right.
And a loose fumble. And picked up by the Chargers. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line.
Okay, after those first two drives, I think there's a head coach who's going to be called for CSI. They're going to want some forensics on this. What is going on with this ball club unable to hold on to the football and take care of it?
Yeah, two straight fumbles for them to start out.
Yeah, you would think that this team would come in ready to go. Sometimes just mentally not prepared, and it shows up in these types of plays.
Following that fumble recovery, it's Murray rolling to his right. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far at second down.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10.
Hey, number eight's coming. Number eight's Mike.
Here's Murray. He's going to air one out for Anderson. And this one is incomplete.
That's what you're going to need to do against those big receivers. You got to get in there and get physical with them. That time he got in close, got in tight, and knocked the ball away.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10.
58, come on. 58.
Big ace.
Check.
Here's Murray. He'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
How many times do we hear that third down may be the most important down in football? And there's no better example than what we just saw right there. Forced to scramble, knows where the first down marker is, dives for it, and gets it. What a big-time play, putting his body on the line to pick up a key first down.
On first and 10, here's Murray, eluding the pressure right. Looking sideline, incomplete.
As soon as I saw him break contain and get outside, my first thought and my eyes gravitated downfield, because nowadays, most of these quarterbacks, when they do that, they want the big play downfield. They don't want to throw it short. In this case, he took the shot. It fell incomplete.
They'll get only a couple down to the 44. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two, because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
And a line to gain here is the 37 on third down. To throw is Murray. And a dangerous throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
The one with the dive look that time on defense just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
And Tucker's kick right there, it's good. And that'll make it 6-0 here in the first. So scores on their first two possessions, but 6-0, so field goal is probably not what they were hoping for.
Yeah, you're exactly right about that. Not what they were hoping for, but they should be happy that they have points on the board. It almost feels like that old slow and steady wins the race, doesn't it? In this case, though, they want to be slow and steady now, but get explosive later and put the points up on the board.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And last time, the turnover on the fumble, and they were in enemy territory, so that had to be very frustrating. Down on the scoreboard here, can't do it again.
You nailed every part of what was frustrating.
Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted, thrown back across his body. Picked up by Xavier Howard. There he goes, right side. And he brings this one back. It's a big six and a Charger team. And tries to stay in the pocket on every play, but I guess that's the danger of getting outside of the pocket, extending a play and making a bad throw. It turns into 6 points the other way.
Yeah, sometimes when you get outside the pocket, your vision actually actually gets obscured a little bit, or you narrow it down too much, and you don't see all the defenders in the area.
Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and the lead now stands at 13. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And he returns this to the 22. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. They find themselves in a good size hole here, and a good size hole early on in this game as they come up on first down. Throwing after the interception. Lance. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Anthony Barr able to drop him that time for his second sack of the evening. And that is the third sack this offensive line has allowed this first quarter.
Yeah, that puts him on pace. Let me do the rudimentary math here. To be sacked 12 times in a game, I know he's not going to go for that. I wonder if it's going to reshape what they decide to do on offense in terms of play calling.
Well, I can tell you what, when he popped up, shaking his head, frustrated right now behind center. A breakdown defensively there as the scramble is going to set him up with a much more manageable third down. 13-0 is the score after one on EA Sports. Throwing his Lance on third down. And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
So it looks like the offense isn't going anywhere. They're going to go for it on fourth and seven. And they'll go for it. Lance in a heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the rookie from Penn State, Micah Parsons. And he brings this six on a Charger TD. A big play there by the rookie. An interception followed by the return for 6 points.
If you want to be accepted by your teammates and coaching staff, make plays like that.
Tucker with the extra point, and that pushes the lead up to an even 20. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. To return, it's Cam Sutton. Now a crease here as he's past the 30. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, we were having a tough patch. This too shall pass. And if I would kept having a rough patch, he said, but you got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. On second down now. It's Harris, and he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Lance now to throw. Flush to his right. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
Only a yard on the pickup, so a good situation on second and 2. It's now 3rd and 1. To throw, it's Lance. He's going to look deep down the field. And incomplete on the deep ball.
Early on, the running game's been working well, and the offensive line has been pleased by that. The thought process there, catch those safeties creeping up, trying to help against the running game. They tried to hit them over the top, unsuccessfully.
And Mike Tomlin going to roll up the sleeves here and say, let's go for it on 4th. They're going for it. This is Harris. And he is not going anywhere. They'll stop it for no gain. He needed 2, but he doesn't come anywhere.
Chargers.
And the Charger defense stands tall, and they get the football back. The Charger drive about to get going. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three. Now Murray steps away to his left. And a first hookup with his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski.
I just made this one simple. Could he be any more open than he was on that play?
And they lost him going to the outside.
Hard to believe because you go through your accounting on each and every defensive snap. Who's got who, what defense you're in. That was totally a blown coverage.
They fake the handoff. Now Murray. And he's got the hookup here. It's Kyle Rudolph. 7 yards, the pickup there. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Looking to throw again on second down. Murray forced out to his left. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
When you look at the scoreboard, you'd think they'd be pretty comfortable right now with this lead, but these guys are absolutely not going to let up. They want to increase their lead, and they want to do it with a big play. Unable to connect in that attempt.
They'll roll him out right. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. Touchdown, Chargers! His third touchdown now on the year. And the Chargers are able to add on to their first half lead. Tucker now for the extra point. And that stretches the lead to 27. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. Sutton now to return. And he won't quite make it to the 25. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned into six. Chargers able to get the pressure and bring him down. They dial up the corner blitz that time, and it delivers to the tune of a 9-yard loss. Sacks a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Escaping the pressure right. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds.
Looks to me, partner, like he's learned a little bit because earlier in the game, I think he was trying to force a lot of throws into his windows that just weren't open.
Yeah, the interceptions had plagued him, especially a second interception, really a bad throw. So maybe a better decision there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I think he learned from earlier in the game, and he's applying it now.
On first and 10, here's Lance. Catch is made by Marquise Brown. And he's free going down the left side. It's a footlace. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Hollywood, Marquise Brown. His fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Steelers are able to close the gap just a bit. Extra point by Butker is on target.
And the lead now down to 20. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. It's a squibber picked up around the 27th. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
The Chargers take over first and 10.
The Charger drive about to get going.
And with a little under a minute to go, still time to try to put a drive together to add to their lead should they so choose.
Tough running, but not a lot to show for it. They stop him shy of the 25. Now the Steelers use the first of their three timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. From the 24, Murray. The catch made by DeAndre Hopkins. Now he's got this almost to the 40 before going out. That's the number two receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage, and tell you what, a few more plays like that, he won't be number two for long.
Well, that's what often happens when you have competitors running around the field. These guys know where they stand in relationship to yardage, totals, numbers, the whole deal. And let's face it, all of them, they all want to be number one.
And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here, second down. The last run got a couple here, second and eight. Going deep for Hopkins. And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete.
Certainly no lack of aggressiveness here. They were hoping for the home run play to get them 6 points. They're hoping for a catch, maybe a call. But they figure they can at least get into field goal range with a completion.
Murray now to throw. Flushed out right.
Trying to get it to Anderson, but it's intercepted.
Picked off by Cameron Sutton.
And the Steelers are going to take over here up near the 40.
Before we came up to the booth, last thing he said as we were walking off the field, want to play mistake-free football. Well, that just went out the window there with a pick.
And do you remember what you said to me when we were walking up to the booth after he said that? You're like, oh. Fatal last words. Every time we hear that, things tend to fall apart a little bit, and that's what we saw there. Didn't get enough on that throw, and it turned into an interception.
Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Lance now on first down. There goes a deep ball. End zone. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
Similar to a shooter in basketball, just connected on the previous shot. They run another set for him on the next play. Now, we had a guy who made the catch. They tried to get the big one downfield, but came up empty.
So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. And this will be spotted on the other side of the field. It's a 61-yard attempt. And I don't think this has the carry. It does not. It's no good. So that would have been something from that distance, but to no avail. Comes up empty as we have reached the intermission. As we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach? All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. So the Chargers will start the second half with the lead and the football as we're underway in the third quarter. A very interesting call and one that backfires. I know they're losing, Charles, but boy, to start the second half with the onside kick, risky.
Felt like a sense of urgency from their side, coupled with, you and I both know the special teams coordinators, they sell their key plays each and every week to the head coach, don't they? And I guarantee he's been selling this one. We can get it, Coach, we can get it. And that came together with that sense of urgency you talked about.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10.
49's the mic. Watch 49. Watch the play.
Murray going to throw. Going deep for Hopkins. Into a double team, and it's intercepted.
picked off by Jordan Poyer. And the Steelers are going to take over once again with a football at their own 20-yard line. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And they've got to be a little bit frustrated about that last drive, missed field goal.
Always hurts a team because, you know, you've put something out there, you've given yourself a chance, you're in range, and the ball doesn't go through the post. But it's not something to panic about, I don't believe. Just keep playing and keep going.
Eluding the pressure right. And he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35.
Well, he's proven real effective running the football. No one open, don't force it. Just get what you can, and that's what he's done very well in this game.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. A run with Harris out of the shotgun. And he'll rumble for about 5, up close to the 40. The first down run got 5. Here's second and 5. And now they'll throw with Lance. This is caught. It's Brown.
I'm the best in the game. I'm the best
and
in the game.
And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Now, this is something that we saw quite a bit at Oklahoma, and we'll be seeing it more and more on the NFL level as well. Marquise Brown going Hollywood.
And that's the kind of play where you have to kind of catch your breath afterwards to just give me a second here, because when he shifted into high gear, he was an absolute blur out there. No substitute for speed. We talk about that all the time. The evidence was right there.
Very short kick. This will be taken by. Now a hit and a loose football. And it's picked up by the Steelers. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. And now, as with every potential turnover, they're going to take a second look at this just to make sure. So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble. The Charger drive about to get going.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up third down.
I'm getting a sense that the momentum of this game is changing since the break. Nice play there, and this D is fired up.
Murray to throw on third and 1. Flush to his right. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds.
Now that definitely hurts, because the mindset is getting a 3-and-out there, and they don't get it done. They give up the scramble and a pickup for a first down.
And now Murray's going to set up the throw. Being chased out left. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
From the gun, he'll hand this off. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
Murray now. He's got the first down here inside the 30 and down to the 28-yard line.
Now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a 2-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
Now Murray off play action. Looking for the end zone. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by A.J. Terrell. And And the Steelers are going to have it here at their own 9-yard line. They exited the pocket trying to improvise. That was a tough throw, and unfortunately, it wound up in the wrong pair of hands.
And Brandon, when you're on the run, sometimes your downfield vision can get skewed just a bit. Now, the beauty of extending a play is sometimes your receivers find their way open, but oftentimes you end up closing down part of the field and bringing those defenders to the ball, and that one was picked off.
Now whistles here before the snap, and it looks like one of the Steelers may have moved. And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. Throwing now is Lance. And that's off the mark, incomplete.
You can tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so they dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. From the gun, it's Lance. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. Picked off by Fabian Moreau. And he is not quite going to make it all the way in. They'll mark him down right about the 1-yard line. He's had a fantastic rookie season, made a lot of lovely throws, but that wasn't one of them.
Well, we got to give him one, don't we? I mean, with the year he's having, a lot easier for he and his team.
And he's in for a Charger touchdown. Andy Janovich, his first touchdown on the year. And the Chargers capitalize on the short field as they take it in for six. It appears they're going to throw for it with Murray. And he's going to go down. Can't get rid of it. So a sack on the two-point try. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily to look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. Third quarter now from SoFi Stadium. Here's a second and 10. Lance looking to throw it. He's got his target. It's the tight end Knox. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. Throwing on first down is Lance. Escaping the pressure right. He's going to be out of bounds on what's going to wind up being the final play of quarter number three. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Working with second and five now. Here's Lance to throw it. Flushed out right. And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
Now a first down carry for Harris. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. In need of only about the length of the football here on second down. The Lance going to throw. Eluding the pressure right. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
I know he was trying to get the completion downfield, but the way this game has gone, with a few of the runs he's made along the way, he should have kept the ball and taken it with his feet downfield. That's the big play that shreds the defense. Instead, he thought to himself, I'm a quarterback. I've got to throw it.
He bailed out the defense with that incompletion.
99 yards on the ground for him now as he has gotten better, really, as the night's gone on. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Harris. And he's in. Touchdown, Steelers. Najee Harris, his ninth touchdown of the season. And the Steelers have got it back to a two-score game here in the fourth. They'll try and throw for it. He'll buy some time right. And he's going to get in. So they're back within 11. So the signal caller doing it himself there on the two-point try.
You got to like that. We always talk about the ball staying in the hands of the best players. But most of the time, you want to get it to a back, pitch it to a wide receiver. In this case, the quarterback did it himself.
Short kick. One of the up middle take it down. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Charger drive about to get going. They have to like the position that they are in. Fourth quarter, two-score lead, and now the ball back after the INT. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
From the gun, they'll try to run it. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line.
Well, I don't think there's any question, Brandon, at this stage. The stop troops, the defensive guys, they've got to use their three timeouts here. They've got to stop them and get the ball back.
Yeah, if you're in that 2-3 score deficit window that they're in now, you got to get it ASAP.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Stop them, use your timeouts. Easier to move the ball on offense without timeouts than to stop them on defense without using them.
And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30.
Partner, I like that they're staying aggressive on offense because, to me, this drive is what is known as a put-away drive. You score here, that might put this one to bed. I like the fact that they're playing with confidence and not playing with fear.
He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of six.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. From the 25 on second down, Murray dancing to his left. And his throw is going to be incomplete. The Pro Bowler DeAndre Hopkins, the intended receiver. And now it's third down. You and I watched film yesterday, and you told me to watch his feet. Well, for whatever reason, his footwork just looked off on that throw.
And you always love it when an ex-defensive back talks quarterback mechanics, right?
Well, but you're good at it.
Well, I try, all right? I don't know how good I am, but it doesn't take much to tell. His mechanics are off a little bit, exactly what you described. Footwork, that led to the incompletion.
And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10.
First and 10 at the 16-yard line.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Charger football as we welcome you back from the two-minute warning. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory. And he takes it in for a Charger touchdown. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Chargers look like they're going to get back in the win column as they extend their lead here this fourth quarter. Tucker able to connect on the extra point. And the lead is up to 18 now. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. Sutton now to return. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
that's all that's left, because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it, because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now. And if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments of this one. On second down, it's Harris. After getting stuffed on first down, not much better there. 2-yard gain. From the gun on third down, Lance buying time to his left. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Dante Jackson picks it. And the Chargers are going to take possession here at their own 6-yard line. Well, you just kind of feel for him right now. 4 interceptions, and you can almost see through his face mask. There's a lot going on in between the ears.
There certainly is, and probably way too much, because now he's probably doubting himself a little bit, wondering what adjustments he has to make. But here's what he needs to do. Get through this game, go to the press conference, meet it head on, and show your teammates you're ready to shoulder what happened today, and you'll be ready for the next game.
And if he can do that as a rookie, that's a great sign of maturity. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. Just like that, out of danger, and up past the 40 now for first and 10.
First and 10, 42-yard line.
Back to throw it, Murray. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
Normally we talk about a quarterback duel where they're matching each other pass for pass. How about the footwork in this one? Both of these guys running the ball well.
Yeah, they've mixed in the run game. You're exactly right. Now, both coaches might not like how much their quarterbacks have taken off, but another example right there of just good mobility. He'll go up top here for Hamler. And this is caught inside the 5. And he's in for a Charger touchdown. It's so easy to focus on the speed and elusiveness of Kyler Murray, but as he shows right there, don't sleep on the arm strength. Now Tucker to add the PAT. And his kick is good, and flags fly as well. Some frustration showing through right now. This is going to be a roughing call, so they elect to decline it.
And why not? Just go ahead and let the play stand, and they'll take that.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. Kicks it on the ground with a squib. Now a hit and a loose football. And picked up by the Chargers. And that might just submit it. Touchdown. The Turtles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. What were they thinking on offense?
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points. Continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, I just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for the Chargers, they keep pace for a playoff spot as they move to 7-3.
Talking about making industry music. They want me to count to y'all, but ain't gonna count to y'all, cause y'all went there when they ain't had a ball. He took his body, wonder how he felt watching his dog basketball. I had to tell my wife to stop. He don't like the basketball. I'm a big hit. I'm kicking in houses for it. Got 2 different tickets, right? Oh, yeah, they loud, boy. Them players late.
making industry music. They want me to cap to y'all, but ain't gon' cap to y'all, cause y'all went there when they ain't had a ball. He talking sporty, wonder how he felt watching his dog cast the ball. I had to tell my wife to stop, he don't like to pass the ball. I wonder where that low was at, it was me against the wall. I was out here running plays, guess it paid off after all. 13 fat girl, her hat just got a star. She got a stitch and I got a stitches, we won't be sparing you. Chasing who? Pursuing who? I won't be chasing you. I'm 4-1, I lost the cap, I'ma charge it to the game. 4-3-8 is not a game, it's just a music thing. Last player got out his lane, put right back in his lane. I'ma sit that pat when I get to Cali, hope we get sit back over. Rain in your range, ain't send no players, all I'm getting ran over. Don't spare mine, gon' spare yours, we're not doing this game over. Only been rapping for like 4 months, now they players time over. They talking about making industry music. They want me to cap to y'all, but ain't gon' cap to y'all, cause y'all went there when they ain't had a ball. He talking sporty, wonder how he felt watching his dog cast him fall. I had to tell my wife to stop, he don't like to pass the ball.
Look, I played the game, I missed a shot, I had the answer, then forgot. I knew one day my pop finance, for not, my not, my not, for Lexin, I fell out and cut the check, my not, my not, palaz the set, but I been taking hits like I can die like innocent. Morning the day, the dawn of the dead day, I don't see nothing but red. I gather the blankets and milk and the bread. I come from the east and I'm traveling west. Got a machete, I chop it, the nigga, the serpent, determined, the plot and the threats. It ain't no stopping and run, popping son of God, dropping anybody who next. I want a mansion, I got a million advances, I'm gonna stay in Atlanta. Most of them move to LA and throw all of their money away and move back with their parents. I see the canvas, I got the brush in my hand, the colors are mixing again, grabbing a stick with my hand, I drop my